Aloha! My mission came as a surprise. So on August 10, 2013, I set foot in my mission place at St. Anthony School in Puohale, Honolulu, Hawaii. I was welcomed warmly by the community, the parish, and the academic team of the school where I would be serving as principal. It was a big adjustment for me. I was principal, teacher, janitress, activity coordinator, guidance counselor, name it, then you have it. The school had meager resources, so I had to assume several roles. It was indeed a total offering of self because in the mission, walang alalay. Ikaw lahat, home chores included, and homesickness added. Hindi madali. But seeing the faces of our students, they are of different colors because they come from different races, but mostly are Filipino Hawaiian. And a couple of our students who had learning disability but possessed pure, innocent, and loving hearts brightened my day and energized me. However, the challenge is still on. My first assignment as school superintendent was to increase the enrollment because they only had 70 students there. Usually with that number, a parochial school is closed or merged with another parochial school. But they had high hopes for St. Anthony. Another tall order I found myself in was a mandate to put up the preschool and have it approved as this would help the school gain more enrollees. This had been the ardent desire of the parish council and the academic community, and they had been applying for it for almost 8 years and was not able to make it. They're actually very strict with requirements for preschool. You have to comply with every detail, especially on curriculum, amenities, safety, and teacher qualifications. Kinabahan ako ng gusto kasi I was given only 2 months by the government's licensing committee. Pagsabi ko, Lord, you called me. You called me here, ikaw ang bahala. I will do my best, you do the rest. So I presented to our Nazareth priest director, Father Mari, also a Filipino, a long list of requirements you have to comply with. He told me, sister, given the time, it is impossible for us to get it done in 2 months. I don't know what prompted me, but I just told him, Father, I think we can, with God's grace. I will not give up because this had been the dream of this community. I don't exactly know what to do, but during my prayer, I just recalled, Hawaii is known for its ohana, the proverbial Hawaiian family spirit. So I just have to ask for help, which is actually not my way. Kasi ako po ay mahihiyain kumain ng food. I got used to being self-sufficient. But in the mission, I learned this art. Till this time, I can't explain how, despite the interior challenges and the odds I had to contend with, our dream was fulfilled. I can only say it was pure grace from God. The expenses amounted to $40,000 and we only had $2,000 on hand. I would say then one day, a man came looking for me. He told me he was for a former neighbor of the school and requested me to see his shop and check if I might want some pieces of furniture for the preschool, which are on sale. I went to see, and he had very good pieces, really of good quality and style. But the price ranged from $500 to $1,000. So I backed up and told him, I can't afford, I'm sorry. Smiling, he agreed. Sister, who told you you have to pay? Just get the pieces you want, and I will give them to you for free. I almost cried. Sabi ko, oh my God, you are so kind. Praise the Lord. So I went home with a truckload of furniture. We were even able to sell some pieces to buy the rest of what we needed. But the last problem was the preschool teacher. None among us can qualify. They have a very strict qualification for preschool teachers. None in the community also applied. So suddenly, barely 1 week before the deadline, a lady knocked at my office. And she was an education graduate who had experience in early childhood, and she was just what I needed at the moment. So I hired her right away. So the preschool was open, and seeing the community's joy, I also just felt so happy. Our theme says, gifted to give. But what gifts do I have? Before going to the mission, I thought I had so much gifts to share. But when I was there, I realized I have not much. I can only boast of my weaknesses. And maybe these weaknesses, which I humbly embraced, and my sweet surrender to His holy will, were actually the graces that allowed the Lord to work through me. It was not all about me. It was about His mission, the people I was serving, and Christ Himself. It was there what I discovered, when you depend less on yourself, God can do all this. I just want to end with one event I could never forget. I was walking along the streets of Honolulu to buy some supplies in a nearby supermarket. When I noticed a truck was about to leave, suddenly stopped beside me. And there were four robust men passengers. They were smiling at me. I felt jittery, having all sorts of wild thoughts in my mind because the place where I was known to be the condo of Hawaii and had a reputation. When they shouted, "Hi sister, how are you? We like you," I almost wanted to run. But then I heard, "We like you and we miss you. We miss that habit, sister." Hi, nakahinga ako, and teary-eyed and smiled, gesturing to them a blessing. These men don't know me, but I believe the habit reminded them of God's presence. So what gift have I shared? I can only say, I was just there, present with Christ's presence. Mahalo, God bless you.